Okay, am I supposed to make an opening statement after that? Or do you want to ask Glenn?
What do you tell the team after one like that?
Well, the one thing for sure is I told them this too. We can correct some of the things that happened today. We had too many penalties and we went real sloppy there after we got off to a pretty clean start. We can correct that kind of thing. We can even help do better, I think, on a play like that last play. You know, there's no doubt about that. But one thing that we have to build on after watching this team today is this is a competitive, fighting football team. I love that. You know, when it was 24-14, it didn't look all that good. We were kind of sputtering around. They had their way a little bit, and we came back, scored a couple times, made some plays, and we just kept fighting, right down to the very end. So that was that we can use all that, I think, to, if we'll continue to fight like that and we can correct some of this stuff, then we're going to be all right.
What ways would you like to have seen your guys play that last play differently?
Well, I'm going to have to look at it closely. I think that guy came all the way across the field, and obviously you needed to have somebody in front of him, not just behind him at that point. And so we must have been out of position at that point over there. But he came all the way from our sideline.
You had a third and one, to a third and three. You didn't convert any of them. What happened on those plays? Would you like to take any of those calls?
Yes. Yeah, all of them right now. You know, and when you don't make third and one, it is that should be your high percentage ones, and they were our low ones. We actually, our overall percentage, I just glanced at it, wasn't overly bad, 6 of 13. Had we converted the easier, higher percentage ones, that'd have been a heck of a third down day. I know our last one, we thought we could get the fly sweep in there. We'd been running the power off of that action and had some success with the power, and they stopped it the last time, so we thought we could get that one. And then we ran another play that we'd had success on earlier, and they beat us on the inside with pressure. So certainly we would make other choices or block it a little bit better.
What did you change up to have success in the third quarter? Build the way you did the second quarter, obviously, didn't feel how you wanted. What adjustments did you make?
Well, you know, I think that we hit one of the things that was lacking at halftime was really the running game with the tailback. And we started getting some of that going, which I think really helped the overall game in the third quarter, second half.
How far does your offensive line have to come, do you feel like, after watching? I know you didn't get to see the tape yet, but how far do you think they got to come?
Well, I think that, like I said, there's going to be some stuff technically that we can help with, and there's going to be some stuff we might say, oh, this is, we would rather have the other call, or look at it this way. So we have to evaluate us and help our players technically how to do it better. But I like our group. I think that this is a good group, and like I said, with the effort that we get and the things that we look like we might be capable of doing, I think that it's going to be good.
Coach Jenny, what was the thought process in calling the timeout prior to the Hail Mary? And did you give any consideration that might help them more than you?
Well, you know, I've been through it before and not called the timeout and not felt good about that, just because it gives you one more. They know what they're doing, right? And it gives us a chance to take a look at it a little bit on anything that they might formationally might help. That's all. How do you know? I thought it was actually very good to call it, make sure that we knew exactly where we were supposed to be lined up.
Describe your emotion when you saw him catch it.
Well, I initially thought he was not in the end zone, but I had a really bad view. So, you know, but I also saw the official raise his hands right away, so I knew.
Injury update, Coach. You had quite a few today.
Yeah, I think there's too many for me to just say off the top of my head. I do not have a list in front of me, but we'll get all that reviewed and tell you about it later.
Any idea on Sam?
Yeah. It's left ankle and like a sprain.
How do you tell your team to move on?
Well, I think that I basically told them almost what I told you about. We can, with that continued effort, we can definitely improve some things and change some things to make us get better. And I've got good faith that that'll happen. There was some pretty good football at times today, I thought, by us. I thought Tommy made a lot of nice throws and had some chances at a couple more that were big, at least a couple more. We started running the ball better. We got more people involved. I think as the game went on, except for probably that last play in that latter part of the game, I thought defensively second half was pretty good. So I think there's lots of good stuff there.
Have you ever lost a game like this?
I don't ever remember one. We got, I think that there were more Hail Marys completed last year at the end than I've ever heard of. And we had one completed on us at halftime of the USC game. But I don't remember ever that happening at the end of one of our games.
How happy were you with Tommy's game? Obviously some signs of inconsistency today, but 319 yards and 3 touchdowns. How happy were you with that?
I thought Tommy competed like crazy, made a lot of plays, and I'm pretty excited about where we can go.
Other questions for Coach?
Did he get enough help? Did Tommy get enough help from his teammates today on offense?
Well, I think, like I said, when you look at what we would like, we did it better, but we'd like to more consistently throughout the game be better with our tailback running game, right? I mean, it was not much there in the first half. We did better in the second half. You know, we had Newby had 46 yards, and Amani, they had about four and a half yard average between the two of them. But I didn't think that there was much early at all. Got better, and I think that's one of the reasons part of us got better in the second half. Okay? Thanks.